مرحبا جميعا، يعطيكم العافيه. جاسر مصطفى ووفاء،
مرحبا.
راح نكون معكم ان شاء الله بالفيديوز اللي حكينا عنها في المره الماضيه اللي اسمها كارير توكس، واللي حكينا هي متى راح تصير تنزل. بالضبط كل يوم الساعه 9:30 توقيت قطر.
In the education, it's very important to put the last education. Do not put your primary school or your secondary school. No one really cares about that. Please refrain from that. And then you put starting from the graduation, if you have a graduate, or if maybe some people they have only high school. It's fine if you have only high school. You put half a school, high school, and then put whatever you have, diploma or courses or certificates that you got, and training courses. That's also good. It's fine, but do not put your second. Or primary, that's just plain, as we said. And then we move to the skills. As I said, it's like between 8 to 10, it's fine. Even less, a bit lesser or a bit more is okay, but let's keep it to that. The main skills that you're confident and you're sure that you are competent in. Let's not exaggerate. Think, even if you have only 2 or 3 skills, it's fine. As long as you master them. Do not lie about that, because we all know people actually lie. And then that's it. And then that's it. You may put maybe reference upon request, but that's it. Please, again, no hobbies, and no, I hereby declare that this information is true. No one cares if it is true or not, because the interview will define if it is true or not. Thank you.
Bye. أنا طبعاً thank you كثير للإشي اللي أنا بعتبره كثير valuable، لأنه في أشياء أنا شخصياً ما كنت بعرفها، وأنا واحد من الناس اللي بقابل ناس عشان أوظفهم أساساً. في شغلة مثلاً وفاء ما حطت لنا إياها بالسيفي، إذا حدا عنده volunteering work وين يحطه بالسيفي؟
It's fine, you can add it as at least as point of interest.
So آخر شيء بالسيفي تبغى يحط إذا عمل volunteering work.
Volunteering or let's say a good humanity work or something you can put as point of interest, and then you can put like volunteering work.
طب هو good أو bad إنه يحطهم؟
It's an additional. It is nice الصراحة, but it won't make any much difference for a recruiter, unless maybe if you're applying for let's say international company, let's say. يعني maybe a charity or actually that company has a social responsibilities, it is nice. But if you're applying for a private companies which is like a medium size or something, they really don't care. They don't do it. So it depends on where you're applying, and it depends especially if you're having so many years of experience, then and your CV is already long, you don't have to put it. But maybe if you have like 2 or 3 years and you just want to fill in a bit your CV to look more like mature, you can add them. It is a nice thing to people to know.
طيب هل حكينا عن languages احنا
ونحطهم؟ Languages is part of the skills. You can just put that as a part of the skills. Computer.
مش category لحال languages.
Skills, you can just put skills. You don't put like languages and skills. You can just put the skills, and when you put your computer skills, let's say MS Office or whatever, and then you put the languages that you speak. Do not put like language expert or advanced or whatever. No one cares really. You just put the language that you can speak. Maybe if you have a very basic language in certain languages, again, let's say French or something, you put French and maybe in between brackets you put basic. That's how it goes.
So إذا أنت مبتدئ بلغة معينة حطها عادي. إذا أنت بتعرف French بس أنت يعني شوي خلينا أحكي ضعيف فيها عادي, حط إنه أنا مبتدئ French, مبتدئ Spanish, whatever. و let's say intermediate English ومدر تنج عربي. باي ذا وقت البلدان العربية بس لازم تنحط صح لو بتعرف عربي أو المدر تنج عربي, لأنه
you can put just Arabic model language and then that's it, and then put for me as a person I would just put English, French and Arabic, that's it as total languages, and then that's it, because people usually by the nationality they would know. Because when you put the nationality above you will know, but in case as you said and you don't put the nationality or you're in a country that they don't really care about nationality, especially in Europe, you can just put it as a language, it's an additional, it's nice.
احنا راح نروح كثير ديب في هاي التفاصيل هيك على رواق مع كاسة قهوة انا ووفاء على فيديو ثاني منفصل عشان ما كثير نطول بهذا الفيديو, لانه واضح انه راح يطلع الفيديو طويل. Anyways, بعد الساعة اللي احنا حكيناها, وبما انه عم نحكي بعد الساعة خلينا نتأكد انه احنا عم نعمل ريكورد اصلا او لا. 2000 years later. بعد الساعة اللي احنا عم نحكيها قلنا بالفيديو هاد, فقديه لازم يكون طول السي في تبعه؟
Usually the perfect one from 2 to 3 pages, not more. but if it's less, it's good. يعني do not make it 4 or 5 or 7. I sometimes see CVs like 7 pages, which is like I don't even look to that honestly, and no one really looks to that.
أنا صراحة ما بطلع لا على السيفي تبعته صفحة واحدة ولا على السيفي تبعته أكثر من ثلاث.
هلا to be honest with you, صفحة واحدة or one page CV is also acceptable because it depends on the job or on the position. Let's say graphic designers.
Yes, positions. By the way, juniors كمان عادي يكون.
It is nice.
أنا لما بدور على junior 0 لثلاث سنين ما عندي مشكلة تكون CV صفحة. بس لما أكون عم بدور على واحد 5 years plus مثلاً وبدي واحد يكون في position قيادي ويجي يكون CV تبعه صفحة مثلاً, ما هو واحدة من تنتين, يا إما الخط كتير صغير يا إما مش حاطط ولا شيء.
True.
Both ways ما حيزبط, لأنه إذا الخط كتير صغير he did not pay attention, لأنه لازم تكون مرتب. He did not pay attention, لازم تكون مرتب السيفي, فالخط كتير صغير, فمرات أصلاً يكون عمره كبير الشخص اللي بده يشوف السيفي, فما حيشوف, مش حيشوف أصلاً الخط الصغير. فهي واحدة. الشغلة الثانية إنه أكيد ما راح يكون عنده سكيلز اللي أنا بدور عليها, إذا هي السيفي عنده صفحة واحدة والفونت سايز, راح نحكي عن التفاصيل هاي اللي الفونت سايز اليوجوال, خلينا نحكي 12, فأكيد ما راح يكون عنده مجال يعبي بالصفحة كل الانفورميشن اللي حكت عنه الموقع. سو هاي واحدة من البوينتس تبع اللينث اوف يور سي في, زي ما حكيتي من صفحتين لأربعة.
Let's be tolerate
من صفحتين لأربعة, إذا قدرت إنك أنت تكون بهذا الرينج فالوضع راح يكون كثير منيح.